Let's talk about the drag force on a flat plate due to boundary layer. So let us say this is the flat plate we are talking about, and this is the flow over this flat plate. Okay, and at a distance x from the leading edge, we assume a small length dx or delta x, whatever you want to take it. Let's keep it dx. Okay, so let's zoom on this part. You'll have A, B, C, D. This is enlarged portion of this dx. So at AD or at point A, the velocity profile is given like this. Okay, and at the you can say wall, the shear stress is tau naught, which acts in the direction opposite to the flow, to with an effect of retarding the fluid motion. So this retards the fluid motion. So if you talk about tau naught is equal to mu into the velocity gradient at y is equal to 0. Now let us say that due to this, there is a small drag force delta FD, which is for this section only. Okay, so you will have delta FD is equal to the shear stress into the area. Now area would be, if you look at the plate, plate is this, where the width of the plate is B. Okay, and we are taking a small length del dx, so this is the area we are talking about, over which the shearing is happening. Alright, so it will be B dx. So we will have tau naught into B into dx, that is your delta FD. Now this delta FD, or the drag force over this small element dx, should be equal to the rate of change of momentum over x, or over delta x. Okay. So for that, let's find out the mass flow rate in phase AD, and then we'll find out the mass flow rate out of the phase BC. So for that, we've taken a small strip at distance y, and the height of the strip is dy. So through this strip, the mass flowing is density into velocity into area. So you will have rho into u into b dy. This is the mass flow rate through this you can say strip. So if I integrate it from 0 to delta, you get the mass flow rate in through phase AD. So this is mass dot in, and this is from phase AD. Now there is some mass which is leaving the phase BC, is that right? So that will be equal to mass out, and this is phase BC. So you will have this rho into u into BDY plus curly by curly x of integral 0 to delta rho u b dy into dx. So that is the mass which is leaving the phase BC. Now if you apply the continuity equation or the conservation of mass, you have mass coming in from this, you have mass coming in from this, and you have mass leaving BC. So this mass in plus this mass in is equal to that mass out. So you will have mass in from AD plus mass in from DC is equal to mass out from BC. So to calculate the mass in from DC, so mass in from phase DC is equal to mass out of BC, that is this entire expression. Okay, 0 to delta rho u into BDY plus curly by curly x of 0 to delta rho into u into BDY into dx, okay, minus the mass coming in from this AD. So that is this part. So minus integral 0 to delta rho u BDY. So you can strike off this. So the mass which is coming in from this phase DC is this part. So you can rewrite it, it will be rho curly by curly x of 0 to delta rho u v dy into dx. So that is the mass coming from phase dc. Now we've seen the mass flow in and mass flow out, and then mass flow in from dc as well. Now the mass flow in from dc is at a constant velocity capital U, that is equal to the free stream velocity. Okay, now we look at the momentum flow per second. So if you talk about the momentum flow in through the phase AD, so it will be rho into u into b dy, that is the mass, and if you multiply this with the velocity, because through phase AD the velocity is small u only, so you will be getting a square of the velocity, and if you integrate this, this is the momentum, this is the momentum in through phase AD. Okay, then there will be some momentum which will be going outside the control volume from phase BC. So that would be momentum out from side BC. That will be 0 upon delta. Again, it is going out at a velocity u. So you will have small u square only. So it will be this plus curly by curly x, curly by curly x into 0 to delta rho u square b dy into dx. Alright, so this is what you get. Then you have some momentum coming in at this velocity from the side dc. Now momentum in from dc, now we know that the mass coming in from DC was this much, that is curly by curly x of integral 0 to delta rho into u into b dy into dx. Okay, now the velocity of the flow coming in is capital U, so I'll have to multiply this with capital U and then write dx. So this is small u which comes from this expression, and you multiply this mass with the velocity at which the flow is coming in, that is capital U, to get the momentum coming in from phase DC. So the rate of change of momentum through this control volume would be this minus this minus this. Okay, so you will have rate of change, rate of change of momentum through the control volume. Okay, so BC is this, BC minus AD minus DC. So you can subtract this part and that part, so it will be gone. So you will have curly by curly x of integral 0 to delta rho into u square v dy dx minus this momentum, which is curly by curly x of integral 0 to delta rho into small u capital U b dy into delta x for dx. Okay, so let's take curly by curly x common, and then we can take rho and b dy also common. Alright, so we'll have curly by curly x of rho into b dy into integral 0 to delta, we will have small u square minus this, okay, and then at the end you will have dx. So this is the rate of change of momentum through this control volume. Now this rate of change of momentum through the control volume has to be equal to this drag force. Okay, and because there is no external force which is acting on it, you can write it down like this. So minus tau naught into b dx, this is equal to the rate of change of momentum. So you will have curly by curly x into rho into b into 0 to delta, then you will have small u square minus small u into capital U dy into dx. So this is what you will get. Okay, so let's explore this a bit. You can strike off bdx and BDX from the two sides. Let me take negative sign onto the other side. That will give you tau naught is equal to minus. So let's get rid of the minus, and you'll have integral or curly by curly x first into integral 0 to delta rho. Then you'll have u minus small u into this into dy. This is what you get. Okay, so let's get rho outside, because let's assume that the flow is incompressible. So you will have integral 0 to delta this minus small u square dy. Let's alterate algebraically. So let's multiply and divide this expression by capital U square. So you will get rho curly by curly x into integral 0 to delta. Let's multiply it by capital U square, and you will have small u upon capital U minus small u square upon capital U square. So this would be the expression that you will get. Take this capital U square outside the integral sign. You will have rho into capital U square into this, which gives you integral 0 to delta. And let me take out u, small u by capital U common, and it will give you 1 minus small u by capital U dy. Okay, let's bring this term onto the left hand side denominator, and you will have tau naught upon rho into u square is equal to, this is equal to curly by curly x. If you look at this entire term over here, this is nothing but the momentum thickness. So you will have delta star star. So this equation, I'll rewrite it. So that is tau naught upon rho into u square is equal to curly delta star star upon curly x. This expression, this is known as the von Karman momentum integral equation. Momentum integral equation. Okay, so this is what we needed to derive. Now after this, we will derive the local drag coefficient and the average drag coefficient in the next video.